There are many types of engineering. I'm a civil engineer, and in this project, I'm a project controls engineer.
I have a message for you.
Oh, thanks. Right, great. Morning, Dave.
Morning, Tamsin.
Lately, my normal day is filled with checking and reviewing the schedule to make sure things are on time as we're coming to the end of the job. Okay, so for that to be installed, we need that delivered on site. Managing the schedule, you need to assure the managers that we can achieve practical completion on the date we're forecasting. In my last job, I was based in Jakarta as a commercial engineer, working on an oil and gas project installing pipeline and offshore platforms. I was there for a year and a half, and in my role, I not only learnt about the way the Indonesians do business, I was able to learn their language and experience a totally different culture. For me, these experiences make engineering so exciting.
Cashin Consulting, Ian speaking.
Hi Ian, it's Tamsin here. Look, I've received your facts this morning about...
There are a lot of deadlines that need to be met, and that's weekly, and you need to be organised and structured to produce those. Okay, now that's interesting, because the guys reported that that was in. Looks like it isn't. Okay, I'll go and check that with Jeff.
Neil, as you know, we've got these base plates installed now. I've got on the schedule the digesters are coming in this Saturday.
Yeah, what we've got is the motors need to be put onto the rollers, so we will make sure that happens next week before the digesters come on.
When I was at school, I was very strong at maths and physics, and I wasn't really interested in medicine. So basically my careers advisor suggested that I look at engineering, and I did. I talk to the client daily. I have to deal directly with the project manager. We have to talk to the engineers and the subcontractors on site, the labourers.
Two feeders, and will they be in by Friday? How many days have we got them coming in for?
Yeah, they've scheduled for 2 days, I'd say it'll be about 4 days, so Friday, Saturday you should be finished.
One of the main advantages is that it's very diverse. There are a lot of opportunities overseas, interstate, and also you're only on a project for a fixed amount of time, and this enables you to maintain your interest in a project and then look forward to working on another. We work as engineers ultimately to become project managers. So we actually are managing people, managing parts of the project, not designing the project. But that certainly is also another avenue that engineers can work in. Yeah, I'm proud to be an engineer. I like that I go to work every day, not knowing what I will come up with, never being bored, constantly challenged, and with so much room for growth.
Tamsin's been working on the Bedminster project for about a year now, and we're going to use the basic construction philosophy that we had on the Bedminster project for this job in Vietnam.
Tamsin and I plan to go up next week. One of the concerns that I know I've read about on the Bedminster project is the latent conditions on the foundations. Yeah, when we're excavating materials, need to be aware of a big component of rock. And we probably need to be programming a geotechnical study fairly soon, Roy.
Right, sure.
Roy, I could certainly look at the contract and compare that with the one we've got at the moment.
Right.
And possibly the variations register could help to see what variations we've had compared to that contract.
The weather up there is going to be a major problem. The monsoon season, there's quite a few factors we need to consider in a fair bit of depth there.
We'll reconvene at the next meeting, which will be next Friday, and by that stage we should have determined how we're going to put the bid together and go forward from there. Thanks everyone for attending the meeting.
Thanks guys. I'd better get back to site.